We talk about Faust. Faust is a two-part play and very important by Johann Wolfgang von Goethe. So we call him Goethe. And the play includes a range of styles, themes, forms such as lyric, epic, dramatic, narrative. All these styles are there, even biblical. And the question here is that how does the first part of Faust end in terms of the tragic resolution? So this is the question. What is the answer? Gretchen is served by divine intervention. In Goethe's Faust Part 1, the play ends with the character Gretchen's salvation being achieved through divine intervention. And here Goethe deviates from the traditional tragic resolution where the flawed protagonist faces doom. Gretchen, who is driven to infanticide after being abandoned by Faust and is hence imprisoned, voices prayers in her final moments. A voice from above confirms that she is saved, signifying her redemption through divine grace. The tragic resolution embodies elements of Christian redemption and specifically resonates with the Romantic Age spirit, which embraced elements of sublime religious symbolism and deep emotional intensity. It is very important to know that Faust himself is not redeemed at the end of Part 1. His redemption only comes at the end of the second and the final part of Goethe's dramatic poem. Now you'd learn more about Goethe's Faust. The Faust actually is a tragic play and it is written in two parts. Right? Nearly all of Part 1 and the majority part of 2 are in rhymed verse. There the play rarely staged, and it is one of the best writings by Goethe and also in German literature. Okay, so this play is very important in our Faust series, right? We have also Dr. Faustus, right? So Faust series is very important for any kind of literature related examinations. Okay, so Goethe finished writing Faust, part 2 in 1831, and it was posthumously published, right? Okay, thank you. We talk more about Goethe and Faust in our next videos. Subscribe me on YouTube. Connect with me on Facebook. I am mostly active there. LinkedIn, Insta, everywhere. My name is Avril Mukherjee. Bye-bye.